Hey everybody, it's Boltercuts5000 here with part 7 of Earthbound. In the last episode, we beat up a colorful guy after wandering around Tucson for a bit, and in this episode, we also got a pencil eraser. And in this episode, I have returned to Peaceful Rest Valley. I got healed, although I got into a scuffle with a mobile sprout on the way here that kind of did a number on my PP a little bit. And of course, I would instantaneously rifle another one right here, once this is just gonna be a disasteroid. This is one of the most annoying parts of the entire game, because these mobile sprouts are just so annoying. They'll take your PP, they'll take everything. Just indiscriminately, they'll just take everything from you without a second thought. You'll be going through here, and you'll be like at full health, and all of a sudden you'll run into a mobile sprout, and when you leave the battle, you'll have no PP left, and maybe like a third of your health. Yeah, this is one of my least favorite parts of the game. It's just kind of like I really like the atmosphere, but everything about the actual area and like gameplay wise is like kind of dull. I almost want to say. Anyway, use the pencil eraser on the pencil on the iron statue. For some weird reason, the iron pencil statue was erased. And yeah, now you can proceed through here. I think there's something up there, but I don't really care. It's just a photo man spot is what it is. Peaceful Rest Valley is kind of a messy feeling area. There are a lot of dead ends. It's kind of a confusing layout. There are really annoying enemies like that thing right there, that moving tree. That's called a territorial oak. And the big deal with that enemy is that once it dies, it will explode and do like 300 damage to you, which I can't really handle right now. I did heal. Okay. I just got a travel charm that doesn't actually give me any defense at all, but I think it gives me a slight resistance to paralysis, which is just so useful, it's unbelievable. It's not. If it's not, I lied. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but paralysis resistance is kind of useless. At least for now. It'll become more useful later, but as of right now, it's pretty much completely useless. There's a magic butterfly here, and there's some dude standing here next to a broken bridge. Did you break the bridge? Are you the reason why I can't get through here a lot easier? Okay, no. I don't want to fight you, but I have to because you came here, and I can't avoid him. No, you fall fire to me. These guys are annoying. They dodge a lot of attacks, but they don't do much. They don't do so much damage. I don't think there's one enemy here. That diamond guy who was trying to join the fight before the fight began. That's called a spinning robo. I'm gonna try to avoid it if I can. I don't really care about, like, showing everything in the game, because some of it is just such a pain in the ass, it's not even worth it. But those spinning robos have an attack where they'll shoot a beam that causes nighttime stuffiness, and you'll catch a cold. And what that does is, every turn, you'll lose 4 HP. And that adds up. That adds up over time. It's thankful you can heal it with healing alpha. Why am I wearing my headphones? See, the thing is, I'm recording this on SNES 9X, an emulator. But if you record on SNES 9X, then when you're recording the AVI file, there's no music. It mutes the emulator while it's recording. I can't fathom why, but it does. No mobile sprouts. I hate mobile sprouts. Oh, my soul. Dude! What did I just say? I said I hated mobile sprouts. And what did you do? You gave me more mobile sprouts. Why do you do that? Okay, I'm gonna heal. If you see a magic butterfly at this point in the game, heal before you get it. Yeah, it'll pretty much always turn out better. I should probably make you very relaxed. We're at 4 minutes. Up here, there's a present, I believe, that contains a very useful item. Finally, an upgrade to the Mr. Baseball cap I acquired very early in the game. It's an increase by 9 in defense, 23 to 32, which is very good. I think it also gives you some, like, slight rudimentary resistances to most elements, but not very much at all. Anyway, down there is that this shack will become important later, not much later, quite back quite soon, but not right now, so I'm gonna pretend I didn't say anything. Thank goodness I got through that area without running into any territorial oaks. And, I never showed the coil snake, but I can't really show them now because I'll just kill them instantaneously, but here we are in the next kind of major area of the game. This is Happy Happy Village, a really creepy cultist town. Yeah, as showcased by this really creepy cultist. The because actually underwent some flanderization between the original Japanese version and the American version. In the original Japanese version, they had HH on the front of their masks, and they also didn't have a pom-pom, so they looked more like the Ku Klux Klan, so obviously Nintendo of America didn't like that very much. They call for help a lot. They give really good experience. And they also have a 1 in 128 chance to drop an item that refills your PP, which are rare in this game. It's only one shop in the entire game, as far as I know, that sells PP restoring items. And even then, it only sells PP restoring items that heal, like, 40 PP, which isn't very much by the end of the game. Not even by the time you get it, it's not very much. They're not so tough, though. If you're at the level that I'm at, they won't be able to do much damage to you at all. But yeah, there isn't really much to do here. There's a blue cow over here. If you talk to this guy, I don't know what he says. I'm just a plain old cow, but Mr. Carpenter's messages always move me. Yeah, this town is being run by a man named Mr. Carpenter. I have no idea where the hell that name came from. It's just a weird name. Mr. Carpenter? Like, what, does he paint cars for a living? That's stupid. Oh no. Oh no. Okay. I thought I would be able to get away from behind the house, but I guess not. The insane cult just trapped me. Hey, he actually did. Yeah, these guys won't do very much damage. This is actually a really good place to grind if you're underleveled, but I'm not, so yeah. I can probably get through the entire game without grinding. I've played through it so many times, I know what I'm doing. You wouldn't know that from that wanted police fiasco. Yeah, they give a lot of experience. Like, just that one insane cultist just now gave me as much experience as a mobile sprout and a UFO. And he was about 3 times easier to beat. This shop, I believe, sells upgrades that will be quite useful. How much money do I have? $103. That won't be enough to buy anything. Just rest my jaw for a second. No, you're done with the automatic teller machine, you clawed monkey. Hello there, how may I help you? Can I get you anything? Yeah, the sandlot bat. Well, that's only $98. Jeez Louise. Their offense went up by 7, that's pretty good. People, I bought that in 1 and I only now replace it. Copper bracelet, Holmes hat, ribbon. If you didn't get the hard hat, the Holmes hat would upgrade. So I'm gonna save. And I should be able to get to probably like a couple events from now in the episode. I'm trying to keep the episodes to like 11 minutes and 15 minutes. Or if I can, like 10 minutes and 15 minutes. So just come through this cave, and I don't think there's much in here. I think insane cultists can actually spawn here, but none did, so that's cool. That's kill. And you'll come out in the tree, recognize this, I showed this to you on the way through Peaceful Rest. Dude, how many spiteful crows even spawned have they? That is ridiculous. Anyway, you saw this shack, this is actually where Paula, or Luna, is being kept. Who? Are you Yori? Yori, I'm so glad a boy named Yori was my destiny. I know it's hard to believe. Therefore, I knew that you would rescue me. If you didn't come, I would have had to try to bust out of here. You can't open the door. You'll have to get the key from Carpenter. He's got it hidden away. I heard Carpenter can control lightning. In that case, you should wear this Franklin badge, okay? And you get the Franklin badge. Which is a useful item. Basically, PSI Thunder is an attack we'll be able to access later in the game, and many enemies will be able to use. And if you have that, they won't be able to touch you with it. Hey, Yori, you're just here to bother me, aren't you? You call me Master Pokey. Since Mr. Carpenter may be an important person in Happy Hat, you should join us, but I know you won't. I'm glad I joined. I'm not gonna fight you, but these guys will. Later, Potato. The hell's that supposed to mean? So yeah, he sicks 2 insane cultists and a spiteful crow on you. This is kind of like a storm, I'll read. I'm just gonna use PSI games because I don't give a fuck. Well, if I would get a turn sometime this century, that would be nice. What? What do you mean it didn't work? I'm a spiteful crow. You're nuts. You're insane. I shot out a giant electromagnetic doom explosion and it didn't affect a crow. Well, crow's dead now, that's for sure. I'm gonna get buku experience for that. And if you're fast, you can actually see Pokey run away. If you can get up fast enough, you can actually see he just disappears before he even gets to the cave. It's kind of funny, actually. But go back through the cave and I guess it's on to fighting Mr. Carpenter now. We When you know what to do is so short. There's actually. Let me show this. I'm honoring those who don't pay at the food stand. Yeah, there's a food stand here. We trust you. Feel free to shop here. What would you like to buy? You can buy a fresh egg, or you can carry any more stuff. Oh, well, that's a load of shit. But if you do have room in your inventory, let me just make room in my inventory. Okay. What would I like to buy? Fresh egg. Now you can say how much you want to pay. You can hit zero. You already did not pay. Now if you talk to this guy, he's like, I'm not even going to pay. Unless you didn't pay. Oh, damn! And he fights you. He's just an enemy from Tucson, though, so it's not a... It's pretty weak. Except when he does that, because that's creepy. Let me attack. Dude, two times in a row, man! Okay, there we go. Now he's dead. I think I might actually end the episode after... Because what's coming up next is basically a gauntlet of fights. You won this confrontation, but the good side of you must ache with regret. Ha ha ha. Yeah. Oh my gosh! Yeah, this is what we have to do next. I'm gonna fight this guy. This one guy. Blue. Oh, you'd like to be one of us? Then give up what you're doing, and go meet the Red Carpenter as soon as possible. Oh. Okay, I guess I don't need to fight him. Some of these will fight you, some of them won't, but some of them will. Obviously. Some of them will fight you, some of them won't, but some of them will. But I'm gonna do that next time, because I don't think I can get through this in this episode. So, yeah. Next time on Earthbound, we will fight through all these happiest, and it will be absolutely crazy, because look at how many of them there are.